Welcome to week four of the Plus Nothing journey that we are on as a community. Some of you are not even a part of SouthBrook, and we welcome you into this journey. Jesus started his ministry by telling everyone that the kingdom of God, the place or the realm where God reigns, that's what it always is. Whenever you see kingdom of God, it's the umbrella of God's promises, provision, and power, is closer than ever before. And he keeps this message going by sending out all his followers to repeat his words and to repeat his actions. That's important to remember. He gives them some of his power to heal and to serve. And in this next part of the story, Jesus does some of his greatest miracles. He's able to find enough food for a crowd of 5,000 people with no notice whatsoever. He does that. He walks on water. He heals a man born blind, and not only heals him, but he offers him grace and forgiveness when everybody else wants to shame that very man. He tells some of his best stories over these pages, which I love these stories. Jesus took all the good stories. Most of them are about lost stuff, lost coins, lost sheep, lost sons. If you've ever lost anything like a paycheck or your family dog, or maybe you've had a child wander off in their teens or 20s, then you get these stories. You understand the passion of looking for something you value. You understand just how important it is that everything of value gets found. Jesus also tries to let the world know more about who he is. Again, remember, Jesus plus nothing equals everything. Jesus didn't introduce us to an ethical system. He calls us to himself, and he calls himself, "I am the light of the world, and even the bread of the world." That's what he calls himself. He tries to use these words or these pictures to show people just how essential his existence is and how his presence changes all of the rules. But like a lot of good stories, some of our favorite movies, there's a darkness that is building in the background of the story. And there's going to be this inciting incident where the drama gets increased all along the way. Every time he shows more power and more authority intrinsic to his being, Jesus frustrates the other powers that are at work in the world. People are mad at him. He's frustrating the religious leaders who cherish control and image. He frustrates and threatens the government rulers and everybody who likes things just the way they are. Thank you very much. And they don't want all this possibility of transformation that will upset the social order. And as the tension begins to mount, Jesus starts heading toward Jerusalem. One time, it says he's so intent on going to his destiny of the cross in Jerusalem that some people would not accept him. He starts talking about his own death. Wait a minute, this is not the Messiah we envision, because that's the main reason he's here. He was born to die. He was born to give his life, and that was his purpose. Now note a couple of these questions with this section's reading. One is, what do you make of Jesus being able to do extraordinary things? I think this is fascinating. 100 years ago, we didn't know how a cell phone would work, did we? Yet Jesus knew things about creation that maybe we don't know. Does it seem possible to you or impossible? A cell phone seemed impossible over 100 years ago. What do you make of these stories being told and retold and believed for so long? Again, make sure you talk about them, because that's how they were originally passed on. Second question, do you have any stories of something being lost and found? And what that felt like? That's how God feels about you. Number three, what do you think it was about Jesus that caused him so much frustration and anger to be directed his way? He did not come, he said, to just make friends. He would cause disruption, and he did, especially from religious people. Ponder those things. Ponder those in light of the fact that as a movement, our mission is to connect people to Christ, not religion. And Jesus is the reason for that. Thanks for joining us in week 4 of this Plus Nothing reading plan. Keep with us. Stay with us. Not only reading this story, but allowing this story to read you.